Good evening and welcome to the open event for music, drama and dance. I'm Cheryl Harper and Paul Morris will be answering your questions this evening.
Good evening, everybody.
So you will be muted, but please use the chat facility to comment and ask questions. So the aim of the event this evening is to inform you of the courses available in the Performing Arts and Music Department and to answer any queries you may have. We'd like the event to be as interactive as possible, so please let us know you are here, say hello, hi, and let us know which course or subject area you are interested in. If we can't answer your questions this evening, bear with us and we'll get the answers for you.
We've got a couple of people saying hello, Cher. We've got a message from Kay Burgess saying hello too.
Oh, hi.
Thanks for joining us.
So in Performing Arts and Music, we have a range of courses from level one to foundation degree. This means that you can study with us through your education until you move on to University of South Wales to complete your degree, and that would be the third year top-up course. So we're moving on to level two music industry skills, where I'm going to ask Karen Phelps to give us an overview of the course, please, Karen.
Thank you, Cher. Good evening. My name is Karen and I am the course leader for Level 2 Music Industry Skills at Cross Keys Campus. This course is a 1 year full time and the entry requirements are 4 GCSEs at grade D or above. The course consists of 6 units: exploring music, professional development, music production, sound engineering, self-promotion and a final major music project. The course is very practically based with a mix of performance, technology and written assignment work. It is suitable for performers and technicians alike. The units studied allow for personal, professional and career development in the music industry. There are no exam units in this course. It is vocational and skills based. Throughout the year, you will have 3 major performance weeks where everyone on the course will be involved. The final performance will be the last unit, major music project, where you will put everything you have learned across the year into practice. During the course, you will receive workshops from industry experts, and once allowed, we will take trips to local and national venues to enhance your learning experience. What do we expect from you? Well, we expect an open mind. You're going to study a wide range of music and styles from the 1950s onwards. We want you to be passionate about your subject. We want you to be organised, creative and motivated. You'll have deadlines to meet as you would working in the music industry. The ability to play a musical instrument or sing, even if you want to pursue a technology route, as it would benefit you across the whole course. What can you expect from us? Well, you will be taught by tutors who have and still work in the industry. You'll have supportive staff who cover your pastoral welfare as well as your academic work. And you've got access to state-of-the-art facilities, including recording studios, mac suites, large theatre and well-equipped rehearsal spaces. Studying this course and gaining a merit overall will allow you to move on to a level 3 music course here at Cross Keys, where you can either specialise in performance or technology. Have we got any questions that are coming in? Let's have a look.
Do you have any questions, Paul, there in the chat?
Ooh, sorry, just having a look in the chat. Question from George. He's asking, will I need to bring my own instrument to college every day, Karen?
It depends on the instrument. If you're a guitarist, we'd like you to bring your guitars in. Obviously, if you play piano or drums, we don't expect you to bring a piano or a drum kit in. But yeah, if you've got any personal instruments like guitars or violins or smaller instruments that could be brought in, then yes, it would be helpful too. But we provide all the amplification that you need as well.
That's great, thank you. Guys, if you've got any more questions, just pop them in the chat for me and we'll get back to you.
Thank you, Paul. So we're going to move on to level 2 performing arts, and Danielle Hubbard is going to give you an overview of this course.
Hi, good evening, everyone. My name is Danielle and I'm the course leader for Level 2 Performing Arts at the Cross Keys campus. The course is a 1 year full-time course and the entry requirements are 4 GCSEs, grade D or above. The course in total consists of 7 units, and some examples of the units that you will study include performance project, acting skills and techniques, performing scripted plays, and drama historical contexts. The course is heavily practical based with a mix of acting skill development, workshops, application of techniques, and written assignment work. There are opportunities to work on dance and singing skills as part of the workshops and masterclasses. The units studied allow for personal, professional, and career development within the performing arts industry. There are no exams as part of this course. It is fully vocational and skills based, and work will be assessed through practical means supported by the written documentation. We offer a number of performance opportunities throughout the year, and the studies conclude with a large final production towards the end of the academic studies. We work with a variety of external companies and industry experts, and often run lots of trips under normal circumstances. Students should wear all black flexible clothing and purchase a pair of jazz shoes. We expect students to have an excellent attendance, have a willingness to try new things, be really passionate about your studies, be organised, creative and motivated. You will of course have deadlines to meet and have the ability to work as part of a good team. In return, you will be taught by tutors who have and still work within the industry, have supportive staff who cover your pastoral welfare, as well as staff supporting your academic work. We offer facilities that include a drama studio, a dance studio, a variety of rehearsal spaces, and a theatre. Studying this course will allow you to move on to Level 3 Performing Arts upon achievement of a merit grade or above. Do we have any questions at all?
Oh, question from Charlie for you, Danielle. About the clothes they need to buy, are there any specific things they need to get or just general black clothes?
General black clothes that are flexible, things like leggings and tracksuit bottoms are really good. T-shirts and loose black tops are great as well. We advise against jeans, so anything that students can wear to be able to move from singing, acting and dance classes.
That's all the questions for now. Thanks, Dan.
Oh, sorry, Paul, we've got another question for Danielle from Charlotte. She's asked, is this a full-time course?
It is a full-time course, yeah, it's just for 1 year and it is over 4 days during the week.
And we thank you, Danielle. We've had some questions coming in about music, about whether you would have had to have studied GCSE music in secondary school. The answer to that is no, you don't. We just ask that you are proficient on an instrument of your choice, but you don't necessarily have to have studied music at secondary school. I think that's it for now. Thank you, Cher.
Thank you very much. So we're going to move on to Level 3 Performing Arts. As I'm the course leader, I'll give you a quick overview. So the Level 3, it's Performing and Production Arts course, is under the University of Arts London and delivered over 2 years across Keys campus. This mainly practical course incorporates training in the three core disciplines, singing, acting and dance. The units include principles of performance, introduction to professional practice, performance skills and context, collaborative performance projects. Assessment is through a combination of performances, which are throughout the year in our in-house theatre, projects, practical workshops, and a final major project. Previous performances include Mary Poppins, 9 to 5, We Will Rock You, Made in Dagenham, and many more. Students on the course enjoy regular masterclasses. In the last year, they've had workshops with Garth Hall, West End Musical Supervisor, Lucy Holloway, West End Choreographer and Dance Supervisor for Chicago Tours, Julian Walford, Head of Musical Theatre at GSA, Mitchell Harper, International Choreographer, Opera and Musical Theatre, and Rob Shaw, Musical Theatre Principal Performer, who's recently joined our staff team of industry professionals and workshop facilitators, amongst many others we've had. Our trips include, we have many planned for the forthcoming year, so fingers crossed we'll be able to visit London and Manchester for theatre and workshops and a cruise for year two. This course will provide you with the skills for drama school and higher ed courses for you to move on with your training. If you're passionate about performing arts, aspire to be a versatile performer and are highly motivated, if you wish to train in dedicated rehearsal and dance studio spaces, this course is for you. Any questions?
Yeah, we've had a question coming in from Owen Sher. He just said, can I have a look at the facilities? We've got a video coming up for you shortly, Owen. Or if you go onto the Colleague Gwen website, you can take a virtual tour of all the facilities as well. So have a look at the video and then have a look at the virtual tour. That'll give you a good idea of the kind of spaces you'll be working in.
We've had another question on the chat as well from Megan. She wants to know what qualifications are needed for the course. So for a level two course, it's 4 GCSEs at a D or above. And Cheryl, what do they need for a level three course?
So we're looking at 5 GCSEs.
Is that C or above? Yeah.
C or above. Sorry, Karen. Yes.
Yeah. Great. Thank you.
So next up is level three rock school at Blaenau Gwent. And Dan is going to give us an overview of the course up there.
Okay. Good evening, everyone. I'm Dan and I'm the course leader for the rock school course at Blaenau Gwent Learning Zone in Emmerville. So the Level 3 Rock School Music Practitioners is an extended diploma over 2 years and is a practical course designed to equip learners with skills to succeed in the music industry. There's a strong emphasis on songwriting and artist development incorporated into real life live music events. And over the past few years, we've built working relationships with industry experts who continually share professional guidance and support to our learners and how to succeed in various aspects of the music industry. So there are a range of units that we do throughout the 2 years to give you a range of areas that you can expand your skills on. In year one, you look at a range of music, composing for film and documentary, music events management, where you will run your own event, and live music performance, where you'll work within a band and on solo projects. And you'll also work on improving instrumental performance, which will be based on developing your skills on your main instrument. And then in year two, we will look at composition as a collaboration, where you'll compose your own material within groups, composing for interactive media as well, so for jingles and adverts. You'll also do live sound, music rehearsal skills with ensemble and solo areas and studio sound recording. We'll work within the state-of-the-art recording studio and work when recording with different bands. So we do a range of extracurricular activities and have a range of master classes. So we do our annual EVI gig at Christmas time and the end of year concert, which is in Evervale. And that'll be based around your main music events management course as well. We also have strong supportive links with BIM and ICMP, which are higher education institutions for popular music. And we usually do visits to these institutions, especially the ICMP in London, where you'll work with a range of different lecturers and music industry experts. We also have a range of masterclasses with Camille Hines, who work with Paul Weller, and he will work with you on composition. We'll also listen to you in terms of or music you've created. Richard Parfitt, who worked with Duffy and Dido. Marcus Russell, who was the Oasis manager between 1993 and 2009. And Lewis Gray, who is a BBC Radio 1 extra and DJ. So as well as developing your skills on this course in terms of developing as a musician, you'll also work with other people who will come in onto the course and work with you and listen to what music you've created between year one and year two. And the next slide you see there is just a bit of a course feedback from one of our students, Laura, who is currently on the course and studying in your second year. So that's pretty much the course. Does anyone have any questions?
I've got a question coming down from Philip. He's a guitarist and wants to know what equipment he'll have to bring to college each day.
So basically, if he's a guitarist, he'll just need to bring his guitar. He can also bring a lead. We provide the amplification and the speaker systems if we go through a PA. In terms of other instruments as well, we got keyboards and drum kits, so everything is covered there. And yeah, that's pretty much it really. So just your main instrument if you're a guitarist, and your own mic if you're a vocalist as well.
We've got quite a few questions that have come in about performing arts while Dan was speaking there. So somebody's asked here, Cheryl, hopefully 5 GCSEs will be achieved for performing arts, but would you advise that you apply for both level 3 and level 2 just in case?
It all depends. What do you think? Do you know, if you come in for level 3 and you don't have the qualifications for level 3, we can then put you down to the level 2, which is equivalent to 5 GCSEs.
Great. Another one here from an anonymous person. It says, do you have to have had dance lessons or lots of dance experience to be able to do performing arts at level 3?
No, you don't. We don't expect everyone to come in with experience in singing, acting and dance. So most students have a strong area and then two other areas that they need to develop that little bit more.
And another one about dance here, Cher. I'm mainly passionate in dance, this is from Laura, but love to perform in general. How many opportunities will you get with level 3 course to perform?
So we have quite a few projects throughout the year. Quite a few would be in-house. We also have projects 3 times a year. So the performances are showcases, a musical, a play. So there's quite a lot going on.
Excellent. Sorry, there's a few more questions yet. Another one from Anonymous. It says, do you need a D level for level 2 music or is there a level 1 music? I'll answer that one. There isn't a level 1 music, but for the level 2, you do need the 4 GCSEs level at a grade D to be able to get onto the course. We do offer a level 1 creative arts, but that's based across art and other media areas. So to get in, if you want to be music specific, you need to get the 4 GCSEs. But one of those GCSEs does not have to be in music. Another question from Laura, are you guaranteed a place even if you've achieved the grades, or does your general school reference affect your application? I don't know if Cheryl or Paul can answer that one for us.
No, we don't need the reference from a school. So as long as you've got the GCSEs and you've got a little bit of previous experience and just a passion for what you do, then we'll have a course for you.
Fab, thank you very much, guys. That's it for the questions for a minute.
Okay, let's move on. So level 3 diploma in music. Paul, would you like to give us an overview of the course, please?
Okay, so if you want to study a level 3 diploma in music, you've got a choice of doing that either at Evervale or across Keys. So Dan has just been over a lot of content of the course, so just a couple of other things that we do across Keys. So if you want to work in a rehearsal room, if you want to play with other musicians, if you want to perform live, we do a weekly workshop as well. So a Friday afternoon is spent in the theatre where you'll perform the songs you've been working on that week in front of all the other music students. So it's a great end to the week. So you'll get lots of performance experience. You'll be performing every single week. You'll then do 3 large gigs throughout the year. Those are usually over 3 days, so you'll do a couple of daytime performances, a couple of evening performances, so that's a hard week, but it gets you used to sort of what life is like as a performing musician. Also on this course you'll be working in recording studios, so if you want to be recorded or if you want to be operating the desk and doing that kind of thing, then you can do that as well. You'll be using music software to create music, so as well as developing your performance skills. You'll also be using software, you'll be using a digital audio workstation to create music as well. If you've never used any of that stuff before, then that's absolutely fine. You don't need to have done all of that stuff. That's why you're doing the course, is to get that experience. But that's what we're looking for from you, is a passion for music. Mm-hmm. If you play an instrument, if you want to develop your skills and interest in music, then these are the courses you should be looking at. As well as the course itself, we also do a lot of extracurricular stuff. So students enter competitions. So for example, 2 years ago, a student band went to Bangor for 2 days. So we went to North Wales, stayed in a nice hotel. They played in a competition against all of the other colleges in Wales and did a fantastic job and managed to come third. Every time Colin Gwent has entered the Skills Wales competition, we've always come away with a medal. So we've got a good track record there. We do lots of trips, so trips to things like recording studios. We have loads of guest lectures, workshops. So we get lots of people coming in to show you some different things, to do performances from you. So it's an interesting course. If you're passionate about music, if you love what you do, then this is the course you should be looking at.
Thank you, Paul. Any questions?
Yeah, we've got a couple of questions coming in for you, Paul, here, and for Dan as well on the RSL course. First of all, for Paul, Megan wants to know, is there an opportunity to learn to play an instrument as part of the course?
Yeah, we'll expect you to have some skills on an instrument already, but if lots of students take the opportunity to pick up a second instrument. So, for example, we've had lots of drummers who've picked up bass while they've been doing the course as well. We've had lots of guitarists who've started to do some vocals. We've had lots of general musicians who've started to play some keyboards and so on. So yeah, you can start to learn a new instrument.
Yeah, just to explain, no, we don't offer private individual lessons though, do we, Paul, as part of that?
No, not as part of it.
Dan, for the RSL, Anonymous would like to know, will the RSL course allow me to showcase my DJ skills?
Yeah, it does. We've basically just bought a brand new set of decks in that they use for music production, and that's one of the units we actually do, which is music production. So if you are a DJ, then yeah, we've got the equipment that we can facilitate for those students.
And another question from Anonymous says, can I join the Rock School just in talent alone, no GCSE?
In terms of music, the music GCSE, I guess?
It just says no GCSE, so I'm guessing it's the same qualifications they'd need for the other level three courses, isn't it? So.
That'll be fine. Basically, we work with them and see what skill sets they got. If they haven't got the GCSE music, that's not a problem. We can see how things go and work it like that, basically. Yeah, so that's okay.
Cool. Going back to the DJ skills as well, Paul's going to explain a little bit about music tech in a second at Cross Keys, aren't you, Paul, as well?
I will do, yes.
Okay, I'll move on then. Thank you, everybody. So, as it happens, the diploma in level 3 in music technology, I'm just going to play this short video. Paul, would you like to give us a bit more of an insight in the music technology, please?
Okay, thanks, Cher. So everything you saw in that video was shot at Cross Keys. So you saw our recording studio there. You saw Kyle Evans, who's the course leader for that course. You saw some of our digital audio workstation. So if you're interested in DJing, in technology, in music production, in creating beats, in all of that kind of thing, rather than playing in a band and performing live, you prefer to create music in that direction, then this is the course you should be looking at. So on this course, you'll be using the latest music software to create music. You'll be learning how to work in a recording studio. So that's everything from setting up microphones to operating the big desk that you just saw there. We've got some absolutely brilliant equipment there, some lovely studios. They are absolutely fantastic. So if you want to work in that kind of environment, again, this is the course you should be looking at. Every week you'll be working in sound and lighting. So again, if you're interested in things like live sound, so when you go to a gig, you hear it sounds and looks absolutely incredible. So if that's the kind of area you want to work in, again, this is the course you should be looking at. You'll take part in the weekly workshop, which you talked about previously. So your job in this is to operate the sound, the lights, to make it look and sound absolutely amazing. Again, if you haven't done anything with sound, lighting, recording studios, music software, and so on previously, where you don't need previous experience, again, what we're looking from you is you're passionate about music. So you might have used a little bit of music software. You might have done a little bit of creating some music. And those are the skills we're looking for, which we can then help you to develop. So if you're passionate about music production, about using technology to create music, whether it's in the studio, at a workstation, on a laptop, whatever it is, again, this is the course you should be looking at. Again, on this course, you'll do lots of things extracurricular. So you'll do lots of trips. We'll have lots of guest lectures, lots of workshops, lots of just getting out there into the industry and seeing what's happening. Any questions about any of that, please?
Yeah, we're getting quite a few questions coming in now. Georgie would like to know, will you need to hear us play our instrument or hear us sing just to make sure we can take the course? Now, for level two and level three music, we do ask for you to do a short audition, generally kind of at the end of August, but we do them a bit before the summer holidays as well, just so we can make sure that you're going on to the right course, really. Cheryl, this one's for you. What do you have to do on the auditions for musical theatre level three?
Okay, so we normally run workshops in, so it's within a group. So you'll have a dance, you'll have singing, and you'll also have a workshop where you're given scripted pieces and you work within that group.
Fab, thank you. And we've got a question from Megan who wants to know, what size are the classes? Paul, Cheryl, do you
want to
go for that one?
For music, you'll be in at the moment the class sizes are small due to the current restrictions, but usually it's a class of around about 15 to 20. They are smaller class sizes, so you're not in a sort of anonymous group of hundreds of students. You get to know your tutors, you get to know your classmates really quickly. Just on the auditions, please don't be put off by the sort of audition word. As soon as you mention audition, everybody gets sort of panic attacks. All it is for us to find out what's your current level of ability, is for us to find out what you do know rather than what you don't know, and just to make sure that we get the right level of course right for you.
Okay, is that everybody? Can I move on?
Oh no, sorry, we've got a question about music technology, 2 seconds. On the music technology, do you get to play your instruments as well, or is it purely technology based? Do you want to go for that, Paul?
No, you will get to play your instrument. So you'll get to use it in the recording studios. You'll get to use it at your workstation. So, for example, if you're a guitarist, then you might have written a track. You might have recorded some stuff in the studio. Then you might use your guitar to plug into a workstation and add some guitar parts to that before taking it back to the studio and adding some more vocals. You will be doing a lot of playing. We do like it if you do play an instrument on the music tech course. It isn't essential, but it does help you if you can.
Lovely, thank you very much. I can move on then. So, college life. College life is very different to school. On the vocational courses, you will study theory and practical alongside skills classes. So if you haven't gained a C grade in maths and English at GCSE level, these will be embedded into your main course timetable alongside Welsh baccalaureates. Our facilities include state-of-the-art theatre seating 100, which is fully equipped with lighting and sound, 2 recording studios, dance studio, drama studio, and a variety of rehearsal spaces. What you need to prepare for will be very much dependent on the course you have chosen. All this information is on the course leaflets on the website. Specific information will be sent either in the post or via email.